Hi guys, today we'll be making this train 18. It is one of the most anticipated trains in current times and the most beautiful looking train in India, available in India right now. It's a good train, though it's not available in Maharashtra right now, but I'm really attracted to this beautiful piece of artwork and I'll be modeling this. I'll be giving a modeling tribute to this train right now. We'll be modeling this train from scratch, from blueprints, and within not more than 1.5 or 2 hours. I'll be splitting this tutorial into 2 to 3 parts for ease of understanding. You can speed up the video and you can also get the crux of the matter, that how this thing is created. I would suggest that you can go part by part, because very minute things are also being carried up in the complete tutorial. So I'll advise that don't miss it by speeding it up. Just try to understand the total terminology of this modeling process. So let us start with the modeling of this train 18 train set. So this is the real pick, and this is the one which is modeled by me. So you can just have a look the clean modeling things, even though I have not modeled it to a very great extent with a great lot of details. No, I have not done that. I have just done a very formulaic modeling, not very detailed, but then this is something like this. You can just have a look, the train is over here. So this is the locomotive. Actually this train does not have a locomotive. The complete train is a train set. It's not having any individual locomotive. So this is a complete train set right from the start to the end. This is one unit. This is electrical multiple unit, that is EMU. You might also have heard DEMU, that is a diesel electric multiple unit, but this train is an electric multiple unit. And the rake, the locomotives as told, are comprised and they move ahead completely. Let's start the modeling of this train. So let's go. First of all, you need to take as much as possible images of the train so that you can understand the geometry very clearly. The major part of the train is the front end, which is the most intricate, complex part of the train to be modeled. Anyways, I'll be focusing much on this part. The rest is extrusion and you all can do it. So I'll be focusing on this area. This area is the much meticulous part to be developed. Anyways, let us start making it. Okay, so priorly what I had done is I had extracted some front view and side view. Of course, you will not get any blueprint of this train on the internet, so I have made this out of photos by warping them and just aligning them to the ortho views, but these are not that correct. But anyways, for referring to a geometry, this is much more sufficient. So first of all, I'll go for Rhino 6. I'll wait for a while till my software starts. So we'll be modeling it as fast as possible. Okay, I'll be starting a new file over here, new, and I'll be saying large objects meters. Okay, anyways, I have selected large object meters. Now what I need to do is, I have these ortho views. I need to align both of them. So coming over here, I'll say that this is my front view and this is my right view, right? So what I'll be doing is, anyways, for my comfort, I'll be making this as a side view and this as a front view. Okay, so I'll be going view, I'll be coming background bitmap, I'll say place. Okay, for aligning these blueprints, I have explained this total stuff prior to this also in Apple mouse product, in my tutorial on this channel as well. Anyways, I'll say front, I'll click it, I'll open it this way. You need to make the snap on so that your cursor does not leave any point else than the grid. Anyways, click it, open it, and make sure that you have a center point in the middle. I'll say grayscale, yes, so that my image lies colored. Anyways, then I can just go over here, same right click, and I'll just say side, and I'll place this. I'll make sure that this image matches the top view this way. Okay, and grayscale, yes. So these two things are now in line to my geometry. Anyways, now what I need to do is, I need to make these curves. These are the most important curves. Okay, so how to make them? I'll just go in layers. First of all, for the default layer, I'll be setting up a red color so that my curve will be visible. I'll make my F7, that is grid off. Where should I do it? I know F7 is the thing to do it, right? But anyways, we can keep it on because I need to take mirrors geometries. So starting from this point, this is the point from where I need to start drafting this. Okay, so I'll be making this. One thumb rule is that you need to take as less number as possible to create the curves so that you don't get a wavy surface. Less the number of points, less the wavy surface. Anyways, I'll drag it and this way, and I'll just place it over here this way. Okay, right, I'm just aligning these grid points on the curve exactly as it is. As much as possible, I'll be making it accurate. Okay, I've made this curve, right? Now what I need to do is nothing. I need to do right now, I need to just respect this curve. Okay, I'll move it this way to this point. Okay, I'll say this point is this point. There is a slight mismatch, but never worry about it. We are here to complete the things, and blueprint modeling is a bit of like completely depends on the judgment, the experience you bear while modeling something. So it will take time for you to come in hand, but anyways, once it's in your code, you can just play it with any type. Okay, so this way I have done it. So this is the curve which I am making. You can just have I'll just say, okay, what I need to do is I need to click it and close it away, because this thing is somewhat very different. We need to understand it completely. Anyway, so this is my curve, and you can just have a look over here. I'll just make it slightly inwards so that it comes down this way. So this is the curve which I had made in Rhino. By pressing F10, I have managed this curve. Moreover, what I'll be doing is I'll be making one more curve slightly coming from this point and going down this way, half the way, somewhere here, right? This is coming over here, and this comes over here, something like this. It has to be. I'll join this again, and I'll delete this point this way. I'll make this sharp. I'll make this way, something like this, because it is somewhat near to cow catcher. The cow catcher in this train is also one of the aesthetic point you need to be aware of. Anyways, I'll leave this thing. Now this is the thing that I wish to have. Okay, I'll say mirror, and I'll try to mirror this along this red line, that is X line. I'll say join. I'll join both of them. Once I join, I'll have a jerk over here. Okay, now no matter whether this does not match, because we have matched it at one end, and this is not the exact front view. I have extracted it from an image, so possibly this will be wrong. Anyways, I have deleted this because I can get a sharp wave over here, which I don't want. I'll just move these two points, okay, this way to this point. This is the point that I'm supposed to move it. This exact point. Okay, now this is the curve, the first curve that we have made. Okay, I'll save this file now. I'll just save it here this way. Where should I save it? Okay, I have some folders over here, tutorials, and I'll save it to 18. I think it else. So it's a best practice to save whatever you make. As in India, we are always worried about the power cuts and all this stuff. So we should be very sure that data is very safe at the end. Okay, so I have made this one thing. The second thing I need to make, what I'll be doing is I'll just copy, I can just at this moment I can trim this, because I don't need double of it right now. So I've trimmed it. I can copy this, because less or more, my this curve is somewhat same. Okay, I'll just manage this first this way. This way. We need to play less so that as we have taken a derivative curve. Primary curve, sorry. And then I'm just aligning it this way. Okay. You need to follow this line. Okay. Links to the blueprints are given below. So please help yourself drafting them, downloading them, and working over them. Just don't download it. Try to model this beautiful train. I'll just drag it. I'll say champs. Just move this ahead to this point. This is a bit higher. Not exactly. I guess it is not. It is at the same level. Whatever. I'll just make it this way because I need to make a geometry there also. So this has to be this way. Okay. So again, I'll be doing the same practice. I'll be mirroring this from this point to this point again. I'll say join. I'll say F10. Again, I'll be deleting this, and again, I'll be moving this to the point. Slightly upside. Okay, and on side view, I'll not mirror it. Prior to this, I'll be setting up this curve. Okay. To this point. Okay, I should not change the location vertically because it is somewhat aligned. Yeah, but I can just align this one, align this one, because these are the side curves that are to be aligned now. So this way. Okay, there is a little gap over here. I don't know why they have given over here. Anyways, we'll be taking it, we'll be respecting it. I guess the light canopy is light, is resting there. So anyways, so this is my curve over here. I'll be mirroring this one again. F9, I'll mirror this. Say join. Okay, again I'll say F10, I'll delete this, and I'll move this again. Okay, take a bit high so that my curve is visible. I don't know what is in the real case, but anyways, we just have some photographs to refer for, but we are referring it to the max. So we have this curve right now. Now we need to be very cautious. We need to be very cautious while making these curves. Okay, so we have made these two primary curves. Now what we need to do is we need to make a curve from this point, just make sure that you are in ortho on mode so that you don't go back to the C plane. Anyways, in top view, I'll be making sure that this geometry is something like this, concave types, you know, it's having some sliding. And if your geometry is correct, then what will happen, this complete thing will be very clear to you. That's where the geometry has to be. Okay, and then again I'll be saying okay, right from this point I can just, you know, just a guide curve I have given over here, and again a guide curve over here, and similarly a guide curve at this point, end quad point. I hope that this is the exact mid. I'll just check it out once. I don't know. So this should be the midpoint, perpendicular. Anyways, we'll freeze this up. So this is the curve that we were opting for. Anyways, now what we'll be doing is we'll be making one more thing again this way. In the front view again, I'll be coming over here. I'll be making one line and this line. I'll be drafting, everything is on my control points. Okay, I'll be drafting it this way. I'll be not making it this way. I'll be making it a bit straight, slight curve, not very much. And in side view, we need to make this curve as a, it's not straight one, but kind of this way, so that we can, you know, get this grab curve very finely. Now one of the most crucial part is this one also. We need to fix this up this way, scale 1D again, and I'll be matching this to this point. Let this be a bit outside, bulky, so that it gets noticed. Okay, so now we have these curves in these ways, and again you come down away, you need to select the second thing, that is interpolate points, and you need to start a curve from this point to the mid and to the perpendicular of this. So but you need to somewhat delete this point. No, you can't delete that point. Anyways, you can delete it this way, and you can just, you know, manage it this way so that it does not loses its shape this way. Actually, we have taken a lot of liberty in this, so I would be making it a bit short, because this is not the thing that we were opting for. Rotate it this way. Scale 1D. I'll just select and I'll just scale this. Okay, anyways, we'll keep this and I'll just drag this to this point. I'm just making sure that my curves are not very bulky. It's very outside. I don't want that much outside. Maybe moving it this inside a bit. Just a slight, so that it makes a statement. Huh? Yeah, this much is okay. Okay, now I'll be making again. From this point again, I need to make a curve which comes. You can enlarge it, because if you enlarge it, you will get a correct line. See this, you can make out. Some details are missing because the view is not exact. Front view, right? So might be some of the view details might be missing. Anyways, I would be respecting all the curves that are visible to me, and you should respect all the curves, because even a slight curve, slight geometry will give you a feel of the real one, and it's really very good to model with references and correct places. So these are the curves that I have made, right? So I have particularly made the curve geometry right now. What I need to do is now, what's the take? We will model these all things laterally. First of all, we'll model this stuff total. Okay, so now at this point of time, what we'll be doing is I'll be taking a straight line from this point. This is visible to me, and this till this point. Okay, I'll mirror this with reference to again the mid, and this is what we have taken down. Okay, so I'll be making one more curve from this point, that is a 3-point curve, to, I guess this point is exact, and this is the point where I need to meet it this way. Okay, now I need to take a tangent surface that comes from this point to this point exactly. So these three things are to be trimmed. Okay, so I'll just mirror this as well. Trim. I'll mirror this. I'll join this as well. This way. This way. So this is my curve for the extrusion, which I'll be moving it till this red line. Okay. Till here the curve goes up. So this is my straight portion right from this point. From this point, the straight portion comes down. Anyways, this curve lies from this point to this point. I'll just make sure that my point comes from this point. Okay. There are some more irregularities because this is not a photo. This is a photo that we are taking from. So what we are doing is I'll be making a curve right from this point, this point, this point, and this point. Okay, so I'll be just making sure that this joins over here, this joins over here, and this comes and matches over here this way. Okay, more bulkily comes over here somewhat this way. Okay, so it makes a statement this way, right? So we have made this also. Now what we need to do is we need to make this thing, we need to take it up down below to this point, match this point and the base of the train, and be moving it inside this point, somewhat inside this way, right? From this point, now I need to make a line again this way, which joins this way. Okay, it comes this way below. Okay, here you can just give a fillet or something like that to match the things, or if not fillet, you can just give a tangential circle as well, and then that you can just trim up literally. Depends on the ease you feel, whatever you feel. Anyways, I made this, I join it, and this is my stuff. Okay, you can just round it up as you feel, wish, because it's going to be, I'll just trim it later. Firstly, I need to just make it very clear that it lies on the surface, it does not go out of the surface this way. Okay, and then I can just add a fillet or might be something 5'2" or something. I don't know how much damage it will be taking, but anyways, I'll be adding this way. Trim, trim, trim. Okay, so we have made this. Now I'll join it. So following is the curve of the complete train. I'll be mirroring this again, this as well. I'll mirror F9. Your mid is the symmetry and you should respect it the way it is. Okay, anyways, now let's start modeling. Yeah, one more thing, you'll be making one curve over here and you're running it this way. Okay, and this is something very odd in this case. I'll be making this way as it goes. I'll be adding a kink over here. Okay, the learning the tutorial, the complete one product in Rhino, will make you understand how the kinks work, how the rest of the geometries work. You know, you'll be getting to know how the things work very finely. Anyways, this is the way that we've done it. Okay, anyways, now what we need to do is we need to jot down the surfaces. First of all, let us make the mid surface. We don't have the curve. We have the curve right now. Okay, so the modeling technique we are going to use is the network of the surfaces. Now if we select this, the surface will be looking like this, something, okay, which won't be making any sense. I'll be making a paint that is white and I'll be attaching this to this. So you yourself can see this is not the thing that we are opting for. Anyways, I'll delete this. What we need to do is, it's a simple logic now. Network of curves does have some particular type of networks in them. For example, if this is one, the curve, this is one single curve. This should not be one single curve. It should be split into three halves. I'll just click this. I'll just say mirror, and I'll try that these mirrors are very exact, so that this curve is splitted into two halves. So this is one half, this is one half, and this is one half. Okay, now what will happen when you take network of curves select 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. These are total 6 curves. Okay, the geometry should lie this way. Now the result you will be getting is somewhat very different. We are looking for something very like this, right? Okay, anyways, this is my take on this. Now I'll hide it for a while. I'll be making one. Now again, for this I need to say join. Okay, joining this surface. Okay, one thing I'll be doing is, this is my geometry, right? I'll say Ctrl X so that I have this geometry. I am just rendering it, so this my curve is completely entire. I'll say Ctrl V. I got the geometry. I have my one curve intact over here. What I'll be doing right now is network of curves. This one, this you can take surface. No, you can't take surface. You can take single curve. You can select this. You can select this. You can select these two. Whether these are accurate or not, but these might be accurate or should have been accurate, and I have made this as well. Okay, I'll again say paint. I'll just give the color as Vande Bharat has this color, and I'll just attach it to this one. So this is my geometry. Well, anyways, I am finding some issues over here, so I just have to worry about something that is not part and parcel of this game. I just don't want this line now. Okay, so the curve is not that wavy, and I'll just try also that this goes. I know this is out of the context, but then we need to make the thing look more real, right? So anyways, we need to draft that surface again. I'll send it up. So making a geometry this big is really a cumbersome job, and always you need to be very very cautious in making this kind of stuff. This one, and this one. So my geometry doesn't get that wavy. I'll say Ctrl X, and I'll just take this one. I'll say Ctrl network of curves. This one. So again, this one I'll say point paint. I can give this one the same tone that Vande Bharat has. Ctrl V and paint again this one, the mid one. So this is the thing that we have made right now. Okay, now what we'll be doing is, we'll be making this stuff, this firstly, and then the second thing. Okay, we need to split this curve into this one. Okay, so we have this one. You can just try one thing again, and you can just, you know, just give a rail over here. Again, you need to see a curve. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This one is done. Okay. Again, you need to split this curve into this one. So you get this complete curve. This one. See, I'm just using the network of surfaces, nothing else. Okay, but not every time you can use this, okay. There are also, you need to take away streets over here. I just need to make sure this line is exact straight over here. I'll just delete this. This is of no use for me. I'll just heighten this up a bit. Yeah, to this level, alright. And now from this point I'll just make it visible to this one, right? I'll make sure that I join this perpendicular, and I can just mirror it this way again. Okay, now what I'll be doing is, I'll be just clicking this three stuff lines again. This curve, that's it. Hope so. It gets created. Yes, it's created now. So you can just feel this stuff, you know, this line that you can make prominent after, like, you know. Okay, one thing we can do, that if this is not prominent, we can just, you know, make a slight curve over here. Slight curve like what? Okay, I'll be sharing you. You can control this way. I can delete this line, and you can just, you can just move it this way. So you have a slight curve over here. Now it will be just click, click, and click. So you'll be having a slight curve over here, despite of a sharp curve. You can as good as make it more slight if you wish. One more thing is that you can align history to this. I can just give it this way. Let us say, I'll say record history. Okay, and I'll be creating this one. Okay, so this is the way what we have created, I guess. Okay, so this is what we need to create. Anyways, now if the history is recorded in a proper manner, we can just move these points and the surface will get accommodated accordingly without any hurdles. Okay, so this is also a good tool, right? So you have got this. I'll just mirror this as well. I won't be doing much detailing because we are having a very fast tutorial over here. So we have this geometrical shape. We will save it now. Now we have this thing. I'll join this, and I exactly don't know what the length of the train is, but anyways, I'll be just guessing because I don't know the exact length of the train. So by the photo, I guess this breaks up somewhere 2 to 3 meters from this end, and this is a door and this is nothing. I guess I don't know what it is. It should be a door because there is a stand over here. So it goes long way this way. Just let us say till this point. Let us take it till this point. Okay, and this is a